Hi everyone, it's Reverend Laurie with Unity of Ocala coming to you from my home. We are trying something new this week as another way to reach out to you, to stay connected with you, and to share unity practices and principles with all of you. So let us know what you think, and let us know also some of the topics that you would like to discuss. And I will be happy to share my thoughts about them and other Unity teachers' thoughts. I thought we'd use this time to, in a casual way, just chat about what's going on. You know, Unity is one of the great movements in the world that are really bringing rays of light and hope to a world that right now seems very dark. And I'm so grateful that I found Unity when I did, and I hope that those of you who know Unity, know our teachings, enjoyed this uplifting messaging and tools to help us spiritually and physically handle situations. I hope you're reaching out to others who could hear and benefit from messages of hope. And you know, our board president, Jean Joyner, shared a message recently online that just touched me. You know, every time I do coaching at Unity churches all over the place or leadership training, I like to ask all the members, all the team leaders, all the board members, I want to know what they feel about Unity. What do you love about Unity? And we did that with Unity of Ocala when we went through the appreciative inquiry process to find our shared values and to establish ourselves in a similar mission of great work in this community. And so we asked, what do you love about Unity? And Jean took notes for the meeting and she shared these online. And they brought back so many wonderful emotions for me and wonderful feelings about what people say when they find an organization, a ministry like Unity, and what it means to them. And some of their messages and their thoughts were so profound and deep and wonderful. I'm so happy that she shared that because it really got me thinking. It's been a long time since I stumbled into Unity. And I've shared this story with congregations before. But when I first found Unity, I was in a really tough space in my life. I was raising children, working diligently, trying to just struggle and meet ends and take care of everything that life has. And I found this bright spot. And I went in and something began to open in me that I didn't even know was closed. Something began to break open. And my mind and my heart was open to these new, although familiar feelings and thoughts and teachings. I cried. I think the first month and a half of services, I would go in and just weep. Every message that I heard, every song that was sung, every thought, every book, every quote touched me. It was like a personal love letter to me. And I would think for hours on end, is there really a God like this? Is there really this much compassion in the human spirit? Are we really loved this deeply? I had not been taught that. I had not been taught that God was all love. I had felt more that God was judgmental, and I pushed God out of my life when I lost my father and lost some very important people in my life because I thought, what kind of a God would do that? And then I realized, thank you, Unity, innately we have in us that ability to know more than often we're taught, to know how we feel about things. And Unity helped me get in touch with feelings that I wanted, that I had but couldn't express. It was a freeing, and it began to fill this emptiness in me that I didn't even know existed, and I couldn't get enough. I couldn't get enough teachings and lessons and songs, and I had to keep learning and getting the books. And I loved collecting, and still do, and I have boxes of them, of these great little Unity pocketbooks. Do some of you have these? These were printed mostly in the 30s, 40s, and 50s, but you can still find them on eBay and at the older Unity ministries. And occasionally we share them back and forth, the ministers, but I have piles of them. And I thought, while we wander through these weekly catch-ups and blasting out to you between our service time, we can journey through some of those wonderful old Unity books. They were called pocketbooks because you could keep them all week. You could just slide them into your pocket, into your vest pocket, and you could just have these words of wisdom with you whenever you needed them. So I love their size, their convenience, but mostly the simple messages from way back when, and the messages of today are still relevant. But in those early teachers, fresh from the Fillmores, and hearing their understanding of Jesus's journey and his teachings and his lesson, and how they are eternal and global, and how they match beautifully with other religions that also are teaching a God of love and of joy and of hope and of strength. We're still going to be broadcasting our weekly Sunday services. We've chosen to do those in our sanctuary in the beautiful Ocala Church, because that's home for us, and it feels good to see that on your screen. But then during the week, when I have some thoughts, I want to just be able to go upstairs into my little meditation and yoga room, my little space of quiet. Since all the kids moved out, this is no longer the teenager's den. This is Mama Bear's space. And it's my space. It's just oozing with energy of love of all my favorite teachers throughout the millennia. So I'm going to share those thoughts that come to me, those thoughts you're sharing with me that you want to hear through the eyes and teachings of the great masters. This month, for our Sunday services, we're taking a journey through Eric Butterworth's Discover the Power Within You. That's a classic. It's a textbook standard for Unity students and ministers. His work is phenomenal. This is the one Oprah swears about that changed her life. And we're going to talk about that through the month of Divine Power. So stay tuned with us and let us know how we're doing, and especially how you're doing. Because at this time, it can seem so lonely. I spend a lot of time on the phone contacting people to see how they are, and I'm hearing they're doing well. They have everything they need, but they're just lonely. They're just empty. They're feeling they can't really get motivated to make those changes their house needs, or to read that important book, or they're just kind of in this stagnancy of where are we? We're kind of free falling. So Unity is here to bring you hope, to shed a great light on this period of hibernation and how we're going to come through this together, stronger, more united, and more loving than ever. And so I want to share, before I go, one of the poems in this little book of best loved Unity poems by dozens of different ministers throughout the years. This really sang to my heart, especially during this time of seemingly empty darkness and confusion. Let this resound in your heart. I hope it touches you like it did me. It's called Streetlights by Ruby Glenwell Fawcett. The night is dark and the street is wet with a softly falling rain. The streetlights glow in a yellow row like flowers along a lane. And coming home through the silver mist with a cool wind in my hair, I cannot help but lift my face to whisper a little prayer. Dear God, when the night is dark and long, and the path is dim with pain, let hope and faith shine through the dark like streetlights in the rain. Hold that vision of thousands of streetlights flickering hope throughout the land, across the globe, in this mist and this rain, and this time of cleansing and healing, restoring, and listening to God. Be blessed. I love you. I'm titling our weekly chats Love Notes.